This solar collector provides heat for space heating of my basement, and this mirror helps it. Here, under the transparent film, I placed this black pool solar heater. Obviously, the sun heats its black surface, and it transfers heat to water, which circulates inside the heater. We understand that such mirrors add solar radiation, which can significantly increase heat production and heating temperature of the solar collector. So, during the last winter, I studied this case when a mirror is located below our solar collector. Of course, we can remember this case where a mirror is located above our collector, or this case of two mirrors, both below and above a collector. However, the topic of this video will be only this situation, when we place a mirror below our collector. These cases of a different mirror position will be described by my future videos. My information will be useful for any type of solar collectors, and you can use this information to increase the heating temperature and heat production of your collector. In addition, we understand that this mirror can be not only flat, but also concave. Or it could be several mirrors, similar to this mirror structure, which will be tested by me starting in April. Here I plan to install this receiver, which will produce heat for the hot water supply of my summer cottage. However, my winter experiments were done with a flat mirror, and therefore some of my conclusions may be different for these cases of other types of mirrors. Let's pay attention to this edge of the spot of solar radiation, which corresponds to this edge of the mirror. It is obvious that now solar radiation from the mirror covers the solar collector perfectly. However, this is the situation around the winter solstice, and further, the height of the sun above the horizon will increase day by day. Now I show the situation 1.5 months later. We see that the coverage by solar radiation from the mirror is no longer perfect, and further, the coverage will get worse day by day. We understand that a similar situation will be on the 1st of November, when the height of the sun above the horizon will be the same as the 9th of February. So, November, December and January are months when the mirror can work very well, but the amount of radiation from the mirror is noticeably less in October and February. However, after a few minutes I solved the problem, and we see that now the solar radiation from the mirror covers my collector perfectly. Here we see the curves of the perfect coverage. In other words, I changed the vertical angle of the mirror. But it is obvious that soon this angle of the mirror will no longer be optimal due to the gradual increase in the height of the sun above the horizon. That is why I changed the mirror angle again after 3 weeks, and we understand that a similar situation will be on the 10th of October at the beginning of the heating season. Now I am showing the perfect coverage by the solar radiation after the next step of changing the angle of the mirror. Of course, we can refuse such changes in the angle of the mirror, and therefore it will have the same position all months. A fixed mirror will only work well during 3 months, in November, December and January, and it will noticeably reduce the heat deficit of our solar collectors during these 3 months. But our collectors usually no longer have the heat deficit in March, when the help of the fixed mirror is small. This is my next experiment using this mirror, and I will show how the spot of solar radiation moves during 1 day at different points in time which are shown here. We see that the spot rises before noon, but then it begins to go down. We can understand that the closer to the autumn and spring equinoxes, the smaller the amplitude of the vertical movements of the spot. It was the features of the movement of the spot in the period from October to March, and the movements in the summer will be different. Of course, snow can be a problem for our mirror. Unfortunately, the snow was only 2 times during this winter, and therefore I could not study the snow problem and methods for solving it. It is obvious that snow is not a problem if we place our mirror not below but above a solar collector. In addition, snow will not be a problem for summer versions of our mirrors, but we must not forget about the dangers of summer hail. Of course, my research did not answer all the questions, but maybe I will do it in my future videos. For example, I plan to study the summer version of our mirror, because it may differ significantly from the features of our mirror in winter. In addition, we understand that this option of a small mirror will increase the heat production less than this case of a longer mirror or this case of a concave mirror. We also understand that the optimal tilt angles of our mirror and solar collector depend on geographic latitude, and I remind you that I'm at 50 degrees north latitude. In addition, mirrors can significantly increase temperatures inside your solar collector, and this phenomenon can destroy it. Therefore, you must be careful, and I recommend first testing your collector with this option of a small mirror. After that, you can try to use these more effective options, which can significantly increase the heat production of your solar collector and the temperature of heating its liquid.